Hey everybody, it's Mac from REV Robotics. We're here today to walk through the process of updating your firmware on the Spark Max motor controller by using the REV Hardware Client. So with that, let's go ahead and get started. So what you need to do first is make sure that you have both of your Spark Max motor controllers are powered. And if you are updating more than one, you will also need them to be connected via CAN and have them properly terminated. So here we end up having some terminating resistors on our CAN line. With both of the Spark Maxes connected to each other and powered up. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna plug our leader in over USB and allow it to connect to our Spark Max client. From here, you should be able to see the leader device and also your follower device that is further down on the CAN network. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to our CAN ID device number one. One of the big things that you need to kind of make sure is that the current version of your firmware for the one that you're using the USB to CAN bridge is version 1.5.0 or higher. And also you must make sure that the update for the version that is on the downstream or follower device is version 1.4.0 or higher. So both of these are on version 1.5.0. So we're able to go ahead and update these devices. You can do this in a couple of different ways. First way you can do it is through each of the individual devices update tab. You can go ahead and download and then update the devices individually, or you can click the update all button. So with this, we're gonna go ahead and click the update all button, and it will let us know which devices require updating, what version that they're on, and what version that they're going to, and then we can end up clicking the update button. This will take a moment as it's going to go through and replace the Spark Max firmware on our first controller. We'll then finalize that and then go through and push the update onto our second controller. Please note that it's going to update the device that is connected via USB to the REV Hardware client before it is going to update any other devices that are downstream. So once that's complete, you'll go ahead and you'll be able to see that both of these devices have been updated. There is no longer any warning. You can go ahead and confirm that by clicking into the device and heading over to the update tab for either one of them, and they'll let you know what the current version is running on each of those Spark Maxes. With that, that's the way that you'll end up updating the firmware on your Spark Max devices that are connected via CAN. It's a similar process if you're updating them via USB. You just go ahead and click on the individual device itself and update it in that fashion. You're also able to change parameters on devices over the CAN network as long as it is properly terminated and your Spark Max motor controllers are powered on. If you have any questions about the firmware updating process, the Spark Max, or any of our REV products, feel free to reach out to us, support@revrobotics.com. Otherwise, we look forward to seeing you all at the competition.